the internet is a valuable tool for real estate buyers because almost everything they would want to know about a home or a neighborhood can be accessed from the computer or your smartphone. Well, to answer some questions about the problems you can come up with it too, LinkedIn's real estate expert Denny Grimes is in with us. You can learn just about everything from a house, but not everything you need to know.
No, the internet's really helpful. In fact, 80% of the people that buy a home use the internet at some point along the process. And you can find out great information about crime, statistics, schools, where the nearest Starbucks is. But generally speaking, the most important question a buyer has, and that is, what is the home worth? What should I offer? You cannot rely on the information on the internet.
Right, because there's so many sites, and just about every one of them will give you a different answer.
Exactly, and I'm going to show the audience some real-time information. So we just have a slide showing a house that just went under contract. So this information has not even been downloaded to the national websites yet. So you can see the picture of the home, and the contract was just signed for $300,000. That's what it'll probably close for if all goes well. So I went online and asked three of the major online valuation sites, what is the potential value? You can see that Yahoo Homes came up with a value of $370,000 to $395,000. Now, if a seller happens to look at that, I've got a little argument going on my side. You know, I mean,
right.
The buyer's thinking he's getting a good deal, but the seller's thinking he's giving the home away. Go to Zillow, and they what they call their trademark Zestimate, it said it'd be worth $370,000. And then the last one there, and Trulia happened to get this one right. It said $303,500, and what they did is...
ballpark.
Well, they're in the ballpark, but that's not to say that Trulia is always the right one, or there's going to be one that's right. The only thing consistent about online valuation programs is that they're inconsistent.
Exactly. You said that all they did was get the dollar sign and the three right.
That's in this particular example. So there's a 30% spread on what the home is worth. And the problem with these is it basically, and I get asked about it all the time, online valuations are just a toy, kind of like WebMD. If you're not feeling well, you can go to WebMD and kind of get some idea what may be going on. It might narrow it down to something. If you get really sick, go to a doctor. Mm-hmm. And so for a buyer, if they want some general information about a home or a neighborhood's value, this is great. But they want specific information, so go to a professional because they're going to help understand the nuances because these algorithms that they use in these valuations are blind. They don't consider, like, some of these properties are off water, some are on water.
Right. Makes a difference.
And the computer doesn't know that. The algorithm sometimes doesn't know that. I think in this particular case, Trulia had it right because they were comparing similar properties that were not on the water where the other valuation programs were not considering it. But there's no consideration for the interior condition, upgrades, extra landscaping, other things that add or subtract value from a home.
All those, you touched on it real quickly. The seller you had the same problem with as well. The buyer's thinking, hey, this is a good deal, bad deal. Sellers are seeing that high price and going, there's my price.
Right. It's just it is a general, and I think as time goes on, these will get more specific and more accurate. But you can't rely on them to buy or sell a home.
Is there a rule? Or you just call the realtor when you're looking?
Yeah, I mean it would be interesting. I'd have the audience go in and put in their own address and just look at the variation. The rule is do not trust online valuations.
Simple as that.
Call a professional
or call
an appraiser.
At least get you started. You can learn things about the neighborhood and the house, but not the price.
That's right.
All right, Denny. Thanks for coming in and giving us good advice. If you have questions for Denny, you can email him. It's denny@dennygrimes.com. Maybe we'll get your questions answered for you right here. We'll come back. Top stories, weather, and traffic are after this.